to believe in Allah, the angels, the books, the messengers, the last day, and to believe in the Qadr, it's good and it's bad. And then they are not a believer, they are not mu'min. And particularly, yani this the last that was sent, yani this revelations from Allah Azza wa Jal upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is the Quran.
وقد نوع الله عز وجل بهذا القرآن وبيّن شرفه ومنزلته وفضله في مواضع كثيرة من كتاب الله، في سورة البقرة بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين، وفي سورة آل عمران اللهم لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم نزل عليك الكتاب بالحق مصدقا لما بين يديه. وفي كذلك سورة المائدة وفي سورة الأعراف وفي سائر سور القرآن، فالقرآن العظيم هو الذكر الحكيم وهو الصراط المستقيم، من تمسك به نجا ومن اهتدى به فقد اهتدى ومن دعا إليه فقد دعا إلى الصراط المستقيم. نعم.
The Shaykh continues and he says that Allah Azza wa Jal has spoken of the Quran plentifully in the Quran, and he has mentioned its status and its nobility, and has mentioned this and its excellence in many For example, the Shaykh says in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Alif Lam Mim, Dhalik Al-Kitab, this is the book, La Rayba Fihi, in which there is no doubt, Hudan Lil-Muttaqeen, and it is a guidance for, and Allah says in Surah Al-Imran, Allahu La Ilaha Illa Hu, Allah, in which there is besides him, Al-Hamd, the it is he who sent down to you the book and it is confirming and an attestment to that which came before, the books that came before. We have spoken about the status of the Quran in Surah Al-Ma'idah and Surah Al-A'raf, and in the Quran, Al-Quran Al-Azim, Magnificent Quran, it is also Dhikr al-Hakim, it is the wise reverence, and it is Sirat al-Mustaqim, and it is the straight path. The Shaykh says, we will be saved, and who will be guided, and whoever calls for the correct path.
ومن ذلك الأمر بالإيمان به يا أيها الذين آمنوا آمنوا بالله ورسوله والكتاب الذي نزل على رسوله، ومن ذلك الأمر باتباع اتبعوا ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم ولا تتبعوا من دونه أولياء، فيجب الإيمان بالقرآن ويجب اتباع ما في القرآن ويجب العمل بما في القرآن. نعم.
And the Shaykh says, from this, yani from the rights that the Quran has over us, is the command that has been given that we believe in it. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, aminu billahi wa rasulih, believe in Allah and His Messenger, wal kitab alladhi nazzala ala rasulih, and believe in the book that has been revealed, wal kitab alladhi anzala min qabl, and believe and have iman in the books that and the books that have been revealed before. And likewise, the command that we should follow says, اتبعوا ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم. Follow that which has been revealed to you from your Lord. ولا تتبعوا من دونه أولياء. And do not follow anything besides this. So the Sheikh says that it is obligatory that we believe in the Quran, that believe in that you have an iman in the Quran and faith is in it and acting upon it.
ولذلك يوم القيامة يحاسب العبد على الإيمان بالقرآن من عدمه كما قال تعالى ومن أعرض عن ذكري فإن له معيشة ضنكا ونحشره يوم القيامة أعمى قال رب لم حشرتني أعمى وقد كنت بصيرا قال كذلك أتتك آياتنا فنسيتها فنسيتها يعني أعرضت عنها النسيان هنا الإعراض والترك فنسيتها وكذلك اليوم تنسى وكذلك نجزي من أسرف ولم يؤمن بآيات ربه ولعذاب الآخرة أشدها فتوعد الله وعيدا شديدا لكل من أعرض عن الذكر ومن أعرض عن ذكري والمراد بالذكر هنا القرآن العظيم فهذا عقوبة المعرضين عن القرآن الذي لم يؤمنوا بالقرآن وتركوه نسأل الله العافية
And the Shaykh says, حفظه الله تعالى, for this reason Allah Azza wa Jal, a person will be judged their belief in the Qur'an and its absence, يعني they're not believing in the Qur'an. Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي And whosoever turns away from my remembrance, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ They will have a depressed life. وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى And we shall resurrect them on the day of judgment blind. قَالَ وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا They will say, My Lord, blind and brought me forth blind when I could once see and it will be said to them قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى It will be said to them that our فَنَسِيتَهَا and you turn away from it and you abandoned it وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى and in the same fashion today you shall be abandoned وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي مَنْ أَسْرَفَ وَلَمْ يُؤْمِنْ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ And Allah Azza wa Jalla says that and in this way and like this we will see the bounds and don't believe in the verses of the Lord وَلَا عَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَشَدُّ وَأَبْقَى And indeed the punishment of the hereafter is more severe and more يعني it remains longer So the Shaykh says that Allah Azza wa Jal has threatened those who turn away from his believing in his book with a severe threat for anyone who turns away from Allah's remembrance. And this is the punishment for those that don't believe in him, don't believe in the book.
يؤيد هذا ويشهد له أن العبد إذا وضع في قبره يأتيه ملكان فيقولان من ربك وما دينك ومن نبيك وهذه تسمى فتنة القبر وقد دلت عليها الأحاديث المتواترة عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ففي بعض ألفاظ هذه الأحاديث أن الملك أو الملكان يقولان للرجل ما حلمك بهذا الرجل يعني محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فكل يؤمن هو محمد رسول الله جاءنا بالبينات والهدى فأجبنا وآمنا واتبعنا وفي رواية يقال له ما عملت بكتاب الله فيقول قرأت كتاب الله فآمنت به وصدقت فيقال نم صالحا فقد علمنا إن كنت لمؤمنا وأما المنافق والمعتاد فيقول لا أدري، سمعت الناس يقولون شيئا فقلت. وهذا يبين أن بعض الناس جمعا بين النصوص يسأل عن القرآن، أو أن كل من يوضع في قبره يسأل عن القرآن كما يسأل عن الثلاثة، لأن من الإيمان بالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم الإيمان بالقرآن الذي جاء به الرسول والذي أنزل على الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. فهذا الذي لا يدري وإنما فعل ذلك نفاقا وكفرا. ويا سعادة من آمن بالقرآن وصدق به وعمل بما فيه واتبع. نعم.
And the Shaykh says, حفظه الله تعالى, and that which supports what was previously mentioned is that, and يعني testifies to its truthfulness, is that when a person is placed in their grave, they are approached by two angels. And this is the fitnat al-qabr, it is the trial of the grave, where two angels will come and they will question him, as it is clear in the ahadith of the Prophet ﷺ that are mutawatira. And in some versions of the hadith, it says that they will ask him, this man that came to you, and they will respond, the believer will respond by saying that he is Muhammad ﷺ, he came to us with guidance and clear truth. So we responded to him and we believed in him and we followed him. In other words, it says that the angels will ask them, how did you act upon the Quran? How did you act upon the Quran? And the believer will say that, and it is, we followed it, we believed in it and we followed it. And it will be said to him, sleep, يعني implies, because we knew, we had prior knowledge that you were a hypocrite. When I questioned regarding this, they will say, I do not know, I heard the people saying things, so I said it along. So the Shaykh says, this makes clear after gathering all the verses, it makes it clear, it brings to light that the Quran will also be, you'll be questioned about the Quran in the grave. Because believing in the Quran is part and parcel with believing in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the Shaykh says, what misery for the person that doesn't know or and disbelief, and what pleasure for the person that believes in it truly and follows it.
نعم. ومما يعني يترتب على هذا أن الله سبحانه وتعالى جعل الثواب الجزيل والأجر العظيم والحسنات الكثيرة لمن آمن بالقرآن وعمل به وتعلمه، كما قال تعالى يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات، وقال تعالى إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوى. والآيات في هذا المعنى كثيرة، ونأخذ من الأحاديث قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه، خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه، وقوله صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في حديث عائشة بنت أبي بكر الصديق رضي الله عنهما، قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الماهر بالقرآن مع السفرة الكرام برا. والذي يقرأ القرآن ويتتعتع فيه وهو عليه شاق له أجران. وأخبر أن القرآن يؤتى به يوم القيامة وأهله الذين كانوا يعملون به تقدمه سورة البقرة وآل عمران. ووصفهما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بثلاث أوصاف: سورتان، وصفهما يوم القيامة عندما يرى الناس أعمالهم قال كأنهما غمامتان يعني سحابتان أو ظلتان سوداوان بينهما شرق. والظلة قريب من معنى السحابة ولكنها تميل إلى السواد، ولكن بينهما مسافة شرق يعني فاصل. المثال الثالث: أو كأنهما حزقان من طير صواف. الحزق الجماعة من الطير يعني السرد من الطير مشترك، سرد مع سرد سربان، حزقان يعني سربان، كل سرد مجموعة كبيرة من الطيور إذا اجتمعت أنها سحابة. قال تحاجان عن صاحبهما، يعني يوم القيامة الإنسان لا يجد من يدافع عنه فيأتي عمله بالقرآن فيدافع عنه ويحاج عنه. والأحاديث في فضل القرآن وثوابه في الدنيا وفي الآخرة ومنافعه حديث شيق طويل جدا دلت عليه نصوص الكتاب والسنة، نكتفي بهذا فيما يتعلق بفضله. نعم.
الشيخ حفظه الله تعالى says that what comes off the back of believing in the Quran and following it and acting upon it of great reward and a tremendous recompense from Allah Azza wa Jal and the many good deeds that come from it is, as Allah Azza wa Jal says, يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم. Allah Azza wa Jal amongst you those that have iman amongst you, وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ, and he also raises those that have knowledge and been given knowledge to higher levels. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah Azza wa Jal says, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ, that if it applies to that which is most upright. And there are many ahadith, the ayats regarding the outcome of the person who follows the Quran and acts upon it are plenty. As for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, as is in the hadith of Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, that the people are those who learn the Quran and act upon it. And in another hadith by Aisha radiallahu anha, she said that the one who is skillful with the Quran, al-mahir bil Quran, the one who is skillful, will be with those known. And the one who struggles, finds it difficult, then, يعني finds who recites. Then they will receive two rewards. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he informed us that the Quran will be brought forth. Used to act upon it, that the Quran will be brought forth in the day of judgment alongside those people that acted upon it and followed it, and they i.e. Al-Baqarah and Al Imran, with three descriptions. The first was the Hamamatan, that they were two clouds. The second description that the Prophet ﷺ said was that two as the yani he says that the is similar in meaning, they both is a cloud, it has some dust, and each cloud in each cloud there will be a space. There will be space in between two clouds and the two clouds. The third he said he gave it was that they forward as the Bani Mintay Sheikh Rash Lakh al Hadith, Barakallahu Fikum.
No. Min Bayri Sawaf.
So the Shaykh said the Shaykh says that they were the Shaykh says Hafidhahullah that the third description that the Prophet ﷺ gave these two surahs is that they two flocks of that are in yani lined up, yani two flocks of large flocks of birds that are in lines, that are neatly lined up, and they will come and plead for the person on the day of judgment. They will plead and argue for that person on the day of judgment. The Shaykh says on that day, on the day of judgment, where there a person will be brought forth and they will have no one to defend them. The Qur'an will come forward for the people of the Qur'an and will plead for them and defend them. The Shaykh says that the ayat and the hadith regarding the verses of the Qur'an and the people of the Qur'an in the dunya and the akhirah are plenty, and you shall suffice with that for yani, as far as a hadith are concerned.
القرآن أن يتعلمه المؤمن ويتعلم وهنا الحديث عن هذا الأمر يكون
The Shaykh Hafidh Allah Ta'ala, he says that from the rights of the Qur'an is that a person learn the Qur'an and this is according to a person's capability. So what is upon them is to learn Surah Al-Fatiha and that and whatever is easy for them to learn from the short. This is the best to increase memorizing the Quran and learning the Quran in a correct recitation. And not making and not having any lahan, any and you change and you corrupt its recitation, which changes the meaning of the ayah. And yani reciting it wrong. Its recitation is to understand and to learn its meanings. As the statement goes from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, that he said that a man among us, or someone, would yani study and learn, or when they study and learn 10 ayat and 10 verses, continue and proceed until they understand, yani they learn and understand its meanings and act upon what is yani what those ayat and those 10 ayat mention.
أنه في بيت من بيوت الله يتلون كتاب الله بينهم إلا وغشيتهم حفتهم لا يكفي أن الإنسان وحده يعتمد على نفسه فقط، فإنه قد يقرأ قراءة خطأ وقد يفهم فهما خاطئا. فقوله يتدارسون
الشيخ says سبحان الله that the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
that there is no group of people who gather in a house on the houses of Allah to recite the book of Allah. What enters into this is learning its recitation and memorizing it. As for the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم وَيَتَدَارَسُونَهُ بَيْنَهُمْ that they study it between themselves, that what comes under this is learning its meanings and what the Quran, the message the Quran is giving us, and understanding it. So the Shaykh says that it is a must to gather and join between memorizing and understanding, along with reflecting over the Quran and acting upon the Quran. And in this, there is a great reward, the Shaykh says. And in this hadith, there is a further benefit, the Shaykh says, which is that the Quran, it requires a teacher. And it requires studying. The Quran requires a teacher to teach the person, and it requires that the person studies it. It isn't sufficient that a person, they leave themselves to their own devices and they don't have someone teaching them, because they might recite erroneously, or they might understand erroneously, they might understand the Quran wrong. So the Shaykh says that it is a must, according to this statement of the Prophet ﷺ, that they study the Quran between themselves. The Shaykh says that it's a must that there should be someone that is teaching you and a study of the Quran.
يقولون إن القرآن يؤخذ يدرس القرآن ولا يتولى هذا الأمر إلا من هو عارف به. وكذلك العمل به والدراسة لا يخذر إلا عن أهل السنة والجماعة، فلا يخذ عن أهل البدع. ولهذا ذكر الله عز وجل مثل للتقبيح، فقال مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا بئس مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآيات الله. فهؤلاء اليهود ومثلهم النصارى بين أيديهم التوراة والإنجيل، يحفظون ويقرؤون ولم تغني عنهم شيئا لأنهم لم يعملوا بها وعرفوا معانيها. نعم، تفضل يا شيخ بالترجمة.
The Shaykh with Allah Ta'ala, he says, and for this reason the scholars, they say that the Quran is taken بالمشافحة, that it is taken directly, meaning that a person, the student, they come and they sit in front of their teacher and they look at how, and they observe how the Quran, the teacher is reciting the Quran. And the Quran shouldn't be studied from except, it shouldn't be studied except from one who knows it and recites it well and is capable of reciting it. The Shaykh says that, and it's also not taken, it's only, the Quran is also only taken from Ahl al-Sunnah, and it isn't taken from the people of innovations. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He gives an example uglifying the state of some, where Allah Azza wa Jalla says the example of those that were assigned and tasked with the Torah, thereafter never carried out the task, is the example of a donkey that carries books. What an evil example and similitude for those that deny and belie the verses of Allah, and Allah does not guide those who do wrong. The Shaykh says, those that Allah Azza wa Jalla is talking about are the Jews and likewise the Christians. In their hands they had the Torah and the Injil, and they were reading it and memorizing it, but this didn't benefit them as they turned away from it and they distorted its meanings.
ومن الأمثلة أيضا طريقة الخوارج الخوارج الغلاة وقد حذر منهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وذكر أنهم يقرؤون القرآن وأنه لا يجاوز حناجرهم وأنهم يمرقون من الدين كما يمرق السهم من الرمية وهذا الحديث متفق على صحته وهم كلاب النار في نار جهنم لن ينفعهم القرآن لأنهم فجروا وغلوا وخرجوا عن هدي الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم فلم ينتفعوا بالقرآن العظيم يقول أبو عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما إنهم أي الخوارج شرار الخلق انطلقوا إلى آيات نزلت في الكفار فجعلوها على المؤمنين وهذا من فجور الخوارج وخبثهم فتجدهم يقتلون أهل الإسلام المصلين يستهدفونهم ويغتالونهم ويكفرونهم بغير حق فهؤلاء لا يجاوز القرآن حناجرهم يعني ربما يتقنون تلاوته لكنهم لم يعملوا به ولم يفهموه حق فهم نسأل الله العافية والسلامة ويلحق بهم سائر أهل البدع الذين عطلوا أسماء الله وصفاته كالجهمية والمعتزلة ومن لحق بهم وشابههم من أهل الكلام وكذلك يلحق بهم الرافضة الذين حرفوا كلام الله وكذلك يلحق بهم الذين صرفوا العبادة لغير الله من المتصوفة وأشباههم هؤلاء لم يعملوا بالقرآن ولم يفهموه والواجب عليه على كل مكلف أن يتقي الله عز وجل ما دام حيا وأن يعمل بكتاب الله. نعم تفضل.
The Shaykh says, حفظه الله تعالى, and a further example of those that have turned away from the Book of Allah are the Khawarij. The extreme Khawarij that the Prophet ﷺ warned against. The Prophet ﷺ, he said that they will recite the Quran, describing the Khawarij. They will recite the Quran, but it will not pass their collarbone, and that they will exit the religion just like an arrow exits. It's game. And this hadith, the Shaykh says that there's an agreement of it in its authenticity. And the Prophet ﷺ described them by saying that they are the dogs of the fire, the dogs of the nar, the fire. The Quran, it never benefited them. They weren't benefited by the Quran. They memorized the Quran and they used to recite it, but they weren't benefited by way of the Quran because they distorted its meanings and they went to extremities and they deviated from the guidance of the Prophet ﷺ. So they were not benefited by this, by the memorizing and reciting. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, he says about the Khawarij that they are the most evil of creation. They took the verses that were revealed amongst the kuffar and applied them to the believers. And this, the Shaykh says, this is from the crimes and from the evil doings of the Khawarij and from their their evil doings, that they kill and they murder the Muslims, the Musallin, those that establish the prayer, and they seek after them and they assassinate them and they declare them disbelievers, they kill them. The meaning of that, it doesn't go beyond the Quran. They will recite the Quran, but it will not go beyond their collarbone, meaning that they won't understand it and they won't have any faham and understanding of the Quran. The Shaykh says, what you can include amongst these people is the rest of Ahlul Bid'ah, like those who negate Allah Azza wa Jalla from His attributes, such as the Jahmiyyah and the Mu'tazila, and those that followed their path from the people of rhetoric, and likewise the Rafida, the Shia Rafida who distort the word of Allah Azza wa Jal, and likewise those that can be included in these ranks are those that divert worship to other than Allah, like the Sufiyya and Mutasawwifa. These people, the Shaykh says, they haven't acted upon the Quran, nor have they understood it. Shaykh says that it is upon every person, with yani every responsible person, that they fear Allah Azza wa Jal, as long as they are, yani, so long as they are alive, that they fear Allah and they act upon the book of Allah Azza wa Jal.
نختصر بعض الأمور لضيق الوقت عندي أنه من حق القرآن أن نعلم أنه هو الحق ولا نبتغي الهدى والحق في غيره والقرآن يتضمن السنة النبوية فمن اتبع الهدى من غير القرآن في ما يتعلق بالله عز وجل وصفاته فذهب إلى علماء الكلام والفلسفة فقد ظل ضلالا مبينا فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وكتاب الله فيه الهدى والنور فمن استمسك به فقد نجا ومن ارتاب والبحث عن غيره هلك وضل نعم
The Shaykh says, we shall summarize some points here due to time, and seeks it from the scholars of philosophy and rhetoric. Then they have strayed a far strain. And and the Shaykh says, in the book of Allah, there is guidance and light, and whoever holds on to it is guided, will be guided, and whoever doubts and turns away from it, then they will be destroyed, they will stray and be destroyed.
ومن حق القرآن أيضا ألا تقول في تفسيره برأيك وعقلك وبما لا تعلم، وقد جاء في الحديث من قال في القرآن برأيه وفي رواية بغير علم فليتبوأ مقعده من النار، وهو من قول الله بغير علم فلا يجوز. نعم.
Shaykh Allah Ta'ala, he says, and from the rights of the Quran is that we do not explain the Quran with our own opinions and our own intellects and that which we have no knowledge of. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, whoever says regarding the Quran their own opinion, whoever explains the Quran and says about the Quran according to their own opinion, and in another version, without knowledge, then let him prepare his place for himself in the fire. And the Shaykh says, and this is speaking about Allah without knowledge, and this is not allowed.
ويدخل في ذلك أيضا الجدال في القرآن. فلا يجوز الجدال في القرآن ولا اتباع المتشابه وترك المحكم كما في سورة آل عمران من آيات المحكمات هن أم كتاب وأخر متشابهات ماذا نفعل؟ نرد ما اشتبه علينا إلى المحكم. أما الزائغون قال فأما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ فيتبعون ما تشابه منه. ولا يجوز أيضا الرياء ومراعاة بتلاوة القرآن، ولا يجوز الغلو فيه والتشديد على النفس بأن يقرأ في اليوم القرآن كامل كل يوم، إنما يقرأ في ثلاث أو في عشر أيام أو في شهر. ولا يجوز أيضا أن يرد السنة ويقول أكتفي بالقرآن. كل هذا من الضلالات العظيمة التي يجب الحذر منها. نعم.
الشيخ حفظه الله تعالى he says, and what enters into the rights of the Quran is that we do not argue regarding the Quran. We do not create controversies and argue regarding the Quran, and it is not allowed to follow those unclear verses while abandoning those clear established verses, as is mentioned in Ali Imran, where Allah Azza wa Jalla says regarding the Quran that there are in the book there are clear verses and others are unclear. As for those who have a deviation in their hearts, they follow those that are unclear, seeking fitna and seeking to misinterpret those ayat. The Shaykh says, what do? We return what is unclear to us of the ayat of the Quran back to those that are clear. We return and refer those unclear verses to the clear verses. But the people that are of deviation, what they do is they only follow those that are unclear and they abandon those that are clear. The Shaykh Hafidhullah Ta'ala, he also said that, and it is not allowed to show off in its recitation, and that you seek to be seen and heard when you're reciting. And it is also not allowed for you to go to extremes and be hard upon yourself regarding the Quran. For example, for you to say that I will recite the Book of Allah every single day. The Shaykh says that a person, instead of what they should do, is recite it every 3 days or every week, or every week, every 3 days, every 7 days, or every month, once a month. And the Shaykh says that likewise, that a person shouldn't deny the Sunnah. From the rights of the Quran is that a person should not deny and reject the Sunnah. And all of this above is from great deviations, the Shaykh with Allah Ta'ala says.
Well, Quran Mubarak. Al Quran Mubarak. فإذا قرأه المؤمن فيسأل الله عز وجل به ويدعو الله عز وجل فإن هذا خير ممن يسأل الدنيا ويقرأ القرآن مراعاة للناس وطلبا لما عند الناس فهذا لا يجوز وإنما يقرأ القرآن إلى وجه الله عز وجل وطلبا لما عند الله عز وجل وجاء أيضا في الحديث هذا المعنى
The Shaykh said that the Quran is a blessed book, and whoever recites it, they should call out to Allah and ask Allah by way of the Quran, and they should make dua to Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is better than a person who seeks from the Quran the dunya and what is in the hands of others, or he recites it out of wanting to be heard and seen, showing off, and in hope of people to give him things. So this is not allowed. Rather, the person should recite the Quran seeking the face of Allah and that which is with Allah, and the ahadith all indicate towards this.
نعم لأن الحديث الذي فيه من قرأ القرآن فليسأل الله تبارك وتعالى به فإنه سيجيء قوم يقرؤون القرآن يسألون به الناس رواه الإمام أحمد والترمذي فلا يجوز أن يقرأ القرآن لأجل استجداء الناس وطلب المال من الناس بل يقرأ القرآن ابتغاء ما عند الله عز وجل والقرآن كله خير وبركة لأنه كلام الله تكلم الله عز وجل به وأنزله على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بركاته كثيرة جدا في البيت ويطرد الشياطين وسبب للشفاء من الأمراض الحسية والمعنوية وسبب لهداية الضالين والمكذبين وأعداء الدين فخلق ابتاغوا وأسلموا واهتدوا بسبب القرآن لما سمعوه فالواجب علينا أن نجتهد في الدعوة إلى الله بهذا القرآن والتذكير به فذكر بالقرآن من يخاف وعيد أسأل الله جل وعلا أن يغفر لي ولكم وأن يجعلنا وإياكم من أهل القرآن الذين هم أهل الله وخاصته وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يثبتنا وإياكم على الإسلام وعلى السنة وأن يعصمنا وإياكم من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن وأعتذر منكم لضيق الوقت فقد حانت الإقامة عندنا لصلاة المغرب شكر الله لكم وجزاكم الله خيرا وأستودعكم الله الذي لا تضيع ودائعه والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. جزاكم الله خير شيخنا. السلام عليكم. Thank you.
the hadith that the Shaykh was referring to was a hadith that was reported by Imam Ahmad and Tirmidhi, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever recites the Quran, then let him ask Allah by way of the Quran. Because there will come a time where people will recite the Quran and seek what is in the hands of others. And they would ask others by way of the Quran. So the Shaykh says that it is not allowed for a person to seek, to recite the Quran seeking others and hoping that they can draw in people with the Quran and they should be given by way of the Quran. Rather, the person should recite the Quran seeking Allah and Allah's face. And the Quran in its entirety is khair and barakah, it is goodness and blessing. Allah Azza wa Jal spoke the Quran and He revealed it upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Quran, it flees away the shayateen in your home, and it is a shifa, it is a cure for those illnesses that are tangible and non-tangible, and it is a guidance for those that are astray and those that deny, and it is a guidance likewise for those who are enemies and have enmity to the religion of Allah and to the Quran. Many people, they were guided through the Quran, and Allah Azza wa Jalla guided them by way of the Quran. So the Shaykh says that it is a must that we strive to call and make da'wah to Allah by way of the Quran, and we remind the people with the Quran. And the Shaykh, he mentioned the ayah, وَذَكِّرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ, and remind with the Quran. مَنْ يَخَافُ وَعِيدُ, those that fear my punishment. And then the Shaykh, he made a dua asking that Allah Azza wa Jalla makes us among the people of the Quran, the people of the Quran and His special elect. And he asked Allah Azza wa Jalla that He allows us to be steadfast upon His religion until we meet Him. And with that, the Shaykh ended. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Jazakumullah khair.
Mirar wa the Shaykh, hafizullah ta'ala wa ra'ah, for this beautiful talk. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to reward our translator, Abdul Rahman Sulaiman, who will be giving a talk later on today, inshallah.